we've got photographs of some of the most famous bullfighters in the history of bullfighting. You've got our Corlobes here on this side. This is Miguel Marquez, the greatest matador that Juan Girola has ever produced. This photograph was taken, I think, around about 2001. Terrific bull. If you look at the injury in the photograph, because at the back there, he smashed a hole in the fence with his horns. But the bulls which are aggressive are the easier ones to fight, so I think we cut 2 ears off that bull and we had a great day with him. Terrific bull. Bull from Barral in Seville. An incredible animal. Brave, noble, powerful. All bovines are for killing, all of them. Mm-hmm. Everything that's in England, they don't get killed in bull rings, but they all get killed in the slaughterhouse. So it's a job that you have to do, the killing at the end, and if I don't kill the bull, the slaughterhouse will kill him anyway. I was brought up as a butcher. My father had a butcher shop, and that meant that I went to the slaughterhouse 2 or 3 times a week. And I suppose, in a way, that prepared me for seeing things in the bull ring, because it's far more shocking what happens in the slaughterhouse than... At least the bull is fighting for his life here, and there's colour, and there's action, and there's danger, and there's emotion. In the slaughterhouse, it's pretty grim, and I think most people would be shocked if they went to a slaughterhouse.
This is the gate where the bulls come out here, David.
See these doors in here? The bulls are put into these boxes as they are. They're little rooms where the bulls wait until it's their turn. And they open this gate, they open that gate, and the bull comes into the ring. What it is with a lot of English people is they don't mind you killing cattle so they can fucking eat it. What they don't like is you enjoying it. They don't like you enjoying killing it. That's why they fucked all those people off with the fox hunting. They got busy with them, a section of the public, people who live in the countryside, easy to attack by the city lot, and there are more city people than country people, so they won the battle. But with the bullfight, who are they going to attack? Because the road sweeper likes it, the bus driver, the lawyer, the judge, the waiter. It's in the whole of society, even the priest, the Catholic Church involved in bullfighting. They handle all of the bullfights that are taking place right now in Pamplona. Him that's next to him.
Right.
And him that's next. Son tres juntos, eh?
Tres juntos, ya que.
They look good. You can never tell until they walk around the bull ring, really. But they, compared to what we normally fight, obviously they're quite small. This is a full bull here on the left. This is what we normally kill in a corrida. You see this fellow on your left-hand side here? So, 4 to 5 years old, and these are 1 to 2 years old. It's been a big difference, isn't it? Antonio, he's the corralero. He's the charge of the corrals. No corral bastard. He's one of those guys that has to make his job important.
Yes.
There's fuck all for him to do, really, but he has to make it out. It's like these guys who look after fucking car parks. For the fourth year on the run now, the information from the Ministry of the Interior in Spain is that they've sold more tickets to the bullfight in the last 4 years than they have to football matches. So fucking take that. I was quite shocked when I first started in bullfighting. I got letters from people all over the place saying what a son of a bitch I was. I mean, they're quite offensive people, the animal rights mob. And they think they're violent, they think they're tough and so on. And I've had them run at my house doing damage and frightening my dogs and my cats. I mean, I've got pets at home and so on, and aggravating my family. And the only thing that they know, these people, they're out to give me as much trouble as they can do and be nasty to me as they can, but they don't realise that I'm a fucking Salford kid. And if they want to come round giving me trouble, well, they get it back. And the last time they came around, we give them a good slapping, and they haven't been back since. And if they do come back, well, I'm quite happy to entertain them. You can't reason with them because they're not reasonable people. They have no argument. They just don't like me because I do that. Well, I don't fucking like them because they don't like me, and they can have it any way they want it. This is the one that most matadors will use during the fight. It's not a sword, it's an imitation sword. And it's a lot lighter. And of course, if you fall onto it, you don't do yourself any harm.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the... it's just the simulated sword. Sure. The sword has 2 channels on it. This particular one has 2. Some have up to 4. And you notice that is also channeled. And the idea is to let air in. Once the sword is in there, it causes hemorrhage obviously, but it also allows air in, and once the air gets into your blood system, of course, it causes death much quicker. They've got a curve there so that the sword curves down inside the animal towards the heart.
525.
Well, the bull's life is a series of doors, isn't it? All its life is going between one door and the door closing behind it. To Salford on Sunday night, and I'll be coming back a week later to carry on. Here I am, 50% resident of Spain. I've got residency here, and I spent half my life here in Spain. And when this is over, in the next month or so, I'll still be coming to Spain, and I'll still be involved with the bullfighting world.